Everything is a little bit different here, not only at my home, but also at Westminster Seminary California these days. And my guess is that yours is as well. As I bring greetings from the faculty and staff of Westminster Seminary California, I also want you to know we are praying for you, your family, and your churches, for your safety and your health in the midst of these challenging as well as changing times. We are praying the prayer of Jehoshaphat often, simply saying, we do not know what to do, but our eyes are on you. My guess is that many of you are praying the same prayer. As we turn our eyes to the Lord, we trust that the Lord will continue to provide and protect, and also lead and guide His people. Today, I wanted to take a moment to share with you what's going on at your seminary, some of the changes that we've undergone. As you would imagine, we went to online instruction a few weeks ago. For an institution like ours, who value face-to-face education, transitioning to virtual education was not a decision easily made. Yet for the safety of our students and our faculty and staff, we made the changes about 3 weeks ago, and now we are meeting online, face-to-face in a different way as we engage with our students and continue our teaching. This has not been easy. We've had some hiccups and some transitional issues, but we are so grateful for the technology that allows us to engage and continue to teach. And we're grateful for the staff, faculty, and students who have been incredibly generous and flexible and gracious during these changing times. We also want you to know that our office and our library are closed, again, for the safety of our community. However, the work is continuing daily. We are all working remotely. The executive team is meeting every week on Zoom for us to catch up on what's going on, to think and discuss areas and ways of serving our community better, and also to discuss matters relating to our students so that we can be of service to them. The mail is still coming. We're receiving phone calls, and we're making do with many of these changes, but the work of the seminary continues even as we speak. Many of you have seen, either on video or perhaps in person, our village as well. The Westminster Village was a huge blessing for our institution, and even now, it has remained a blessing for us in the sense that many of these students can remain in their own apartments and stay at home and be safe. We have a lot of children here, and we have a lot of families that are here, and we ask for your prayers as we think about our students and serving them well during these days. In the midst of all these changes, however, we are trying our best, and we hope to continue building our community. We have the technology to do so. So we have office hours online. We have prayer groups that are continuing to meet. As you might remember, also online, we're continuing our Thursday chapels as well. Morning devotions are continuing, so please join us as we reflect upon the leading and provisions of the Lord during these days. We've even had our President's Coffee, a monthly meeting together with students to share with them the prayer requests that we have and also to share with them what's going on campus. Though many things are changing, some things do not change. For instance, our focus on our mission and commitment to preparing future pastors and leaders for Christ's church. I was talking to one senior pastor recently who was reminding me that these are the moments for which pastors are being prepared, so that bringing the gospel hope of Christ Jesus to those who are hopeless, to counsel them in the promises of the word to those who are anxious, and to give biblical longing to the hope that we have in the Lord of that day when we will see Him face to face. We are committed to training pastors and leaders for the church, and that commitment has not changed, and that work continues. What also has not changed has been the support and prayers of our friends and donors like you. So representing our institution, let me say thank you. Thank you for remembering us in your prayers. Thank you for standing by us and supporting us during these difficult days. Your encouragement and your prayers give life to us as we serve the Lord together in this institution that you and I love. So thank you very much.